Hi, it's Carbon McAvoy. I'm talking about graphing inequalities. When you graph inequalities, you have a starting point, and it's important how you represent that point. When you have solved an inequality, you should ask yourself the following four questions. What is my starting point? The number you found when solving is the starting point. Number two, is the number included in my solution? If the equal to part is included in the symbol, it is included. If the symbol is just greater than or less than, the number is not part of the solution. What symbol should I use on the graph to represent my starting point? And you may have seen different symbols in different classes or books, but while they have the same meaning, as you move forward in math, circles will be replaced by parentheses and brackets, so that's what I'm going to focus on in this video. If you have greater than or less than, then you have open circles or parentheses. If you have less than equal to or greater than equal to, then you have closed circles or brackets. And then you ask yourself, the fourth question is, which direction should I shade the graph? If the variable is less than the number found while solving, then you shade left. Remember, left is less. If the variable is greater than the number you found when solving, shade right. So we're going to go through and ask ourselves those four questions for each of the following inequalities. The starting point on the graph I've already put in because it's so obvious. The number that you got is your starting point. That's the number that you want to see on your graph. Is it included in the solution? You look to see, does it have the equal to part? If it does not, if it just has one of these two symbols, then it's not included in the solution. No. So what symbol are you going to use to represent it? Well, if you have one of these, you use either an open circle or parentheses. So I'm going to say open circle or a parentheses. All right. And then you have to decide which direction are you going to shade. And if you're going to shade, you have to look back here and say, is my variable greater than the number that I found or less than? When the symbol opens to the variable, that means that the variable is greater. So x is greater than 5, so I'm going to shade to the right because if it's greater than, I shade to the right. Okay, so let's look what that would look like back when we were using circles. Because we have an open circle, that means a circle that's not shaded in. We have a starting point of 5 on our graph. We don't have to put 15 different numbers and 0 and all that. All we need to show is that starting point. And then we're shading to the right because x is everything greater than that, not included. But using parentheses, it looks like this. We have a parentheses and then going to the right. So it's important that you open your parentheses in the direction that you're shading. Since you're shading to the right, your parentheses should open to the right. Okay, the second one, z is greater than or equal to 4 2/10. The starting point is 4.2. Is it included in the solution? It has the equal to part, so yes, it is included as part of our solution. So what should we use here? We should use a closed circle or we should use brackets, right? And we have to ask ourselves, are we going to shade to the right or to the left? And if you go back and look at your inequality, it says z is greater than or equal to 4.2. So again, if it's greater than, we shade to the right. Let's see what that would look like as a closed circle. It just means that you shaded that circle in. And what that tells you is 4.2 is not just a starting point, but it's actually part of the solution. Since z is greater than that, we're shading to the right. Notice that your arrow to the right or to the left, whichever way you're going, should be obvious. We should also have a complete number line below it, but we only need to have one point on there. And what does that look like with a bracket? It looks like this. Again, we're shading to the right, so our bracket should open to the right, and then we shade to the right a little ways. Notice I have a line that goes to the left of that. This is a number line that goes forever in both directions, and so it should look like that with an arrow on both ends. Okay, the third one, we have 2/3 as our starting point. We are asking ourselves, is 2/3 included in the solution? Well, we see an equal to part, so the answer is yes, it is. Then we have, when we ask that, then what symbol do we use? And we already know we use a closed circle or bracket. And then we ask ourselves, is it going to shade to the left or to the right? Well, since n is less than, it's pointing at the variable in this case, then we're going to shade to the left. I didn't do these circles after the first two because I'm focusing on parentheses and brackets. So we should see a starting point of 2/3 with a bracket opening to the left. And that's what we have for that graph. All right. For the next one, P is less than 18. Is 18 included in the solution? No, because there's no equal to part. What do we have here? A closed circle or an open circle or parentheses? Well, because we have the first situation again, we're going to say that we have an open circle or parentheses. And then we want to ask, which way does it shade? Since it's less than, then it shades left. Less is left. So we should see a starting point of negative 18. We should see a parentheses opening to the left. And that's what we have. You can try these last few on your own, but I wanted to do some where the variable is on the right side because this really gets people confused a lot of times. So is the number included as part of our solution? Well, it has the equal to part, so the answer is yes. And then what symbol should we use? Because we see an equal to part, we should use the closed and or bracket. And then which way do we shade? This is the tricky part on this one. Y is greater than 6.2 because the inequality is opening to the Y. Since Y is greater than, we're going to shade to the right. And that's going to make it look like this. And we have 6.2 as our starting point. We have a bracket and we are shading to the right. And this one, has not been included in the solution because there's no equal to sign. Negative 2 obviously is our starting point. We are going to use the open circle, or we're going to use parentheses. We're not even using open circles anymore. And then which direction do we shade? Well, R is less than because the arrow is pointing at R. So we're going to shade to the left. And our inequality graphs like this, negative 2 with the parentheses opening to the left. And finally, is this 0 included as part of our solution? Well, that shouldn't be negative, just 0. And then it's not included. Again, we're going to have parentheses. And again, we have to ask ourselves, are we going to the left or the right? J is greater than 0 because the inequality is opening to the J. So that means that we're going to go to the right, and that looks like this. It looks like a starting point of 0 with the parentheses shaded to the right. All right, have a great day, and we'll see you next time.